Hello, my name is Ji-young Lim, and I'm graduate student of Bio and Brain Engineering. Today's lecture topic is about an anti-cancer strategy by modulating the cancer cell signaling. We looked upon the basic knowledge last time, and now this lecture is about the new role of ROS. ROS basically is very harmful, but it is revealed that it also acts as signaling molecule. This new concept is proposed recently around 1994. So today, we will focus on Professor Kang's two research articles. One is on the Nature at 2005, and the other one is on the Molecular Cell at 2011. They both focus on peroxyrhodopsin, an antioxidant enzyme, for regulation of cell signaling pathways. So, peroxyrhodopsin is one of the type of the antioxidant enzymes. There are four types of antioxidant enzymes, and only peroxyrhodopsin works in the signaling cascade. And you should know about two cell membrane receptors, PDGFR and VEGFR for this lecture. PDGFR is a receptor for PDGF, platelet-derived growth factor. VEGFR is a receptor for VEGF, vascular endothelial growth factor. They work for cell growth and angiogenesis, and they are both receptor tyrosine kinases. Let's see how receptor tyrosine kinase works. Receptor tyrosine kinase is, by its name, a receptor which phosphorylates tyrosine sites of protein. Once the signal molecule binds to it, it forms dimer and they phosphorylate each other and become an active form. So if we get rid of phosphates, it becomes an inactive form. So let's find the role of peroxyrhodopsin and hydrogen peroxide in PDGF signaling. First, they deleted PRX2 from mouse embryonic fibroblast, MEF, and H2O2 level went up and PDGFR was activated. Thus, we can say that normally PRX2 is repressing PDGFR activity, so it is a negative regulator of PDGF signaling. So the next question is, how did this happen? By PRX2 itself or by hydrogen peroxide? So co-immunoprecipitation results show that PRX2 and PDGFR are co-localized in the cell. Thus, it means hydrogen peroxide near the PDGFR were removed by PRX2 and it impaired PDGFR. So they made a model for this. Oxidative inactivation of protein tyrosine phosphatases. Let's see how this model works. You should follow very well to understand in here. When there is PRX2, it goes to PDGFR and removes surrounding H2O2. Now, PTPase is in its active form and it removes phosphate from PDGFR. So PDGFR is inactivated. If we remove PRX2, exactly opposite things happen. Now PDGFR is activated. We saw PDGFR regulation before. It worked with PTPase oxidation. Now we will look upon the other mechanism. PRX2 acts in opposite ways in PDGFR and VEGFR. In VEGFR, H2O2 directly inhibits VEGFR by oxidizing active sites. No PTPase in here. Thus, we can say that PRX2 is protecting the VEGFR from oxidization. And the interesting thing in here is that they make cavioli structure. Without this, PRX cannot work properly. They are closely located together and PRX2 protects VEGFR from oxidization in cavioli structure. You can see cavioli structure image and VEGFR and PRX in it. And they showed tumor regression in PRX2 deficiency. Because PRX2 was protecting VEGFR from oxidization, removing PRX2 resulted in oxidization of VEGFR, inactivation of it, thus inactivated angiogenesis, and it made tumor regression. If we summarize this all together, the important thing in here is that ROS regulates PDGFR and VEGFR in opposite ways. For PDGFR, they impairs PTPase first, so they activate PDGFR. But for VEGFR, they directly oxidizes them, so they inactivates VEGFR. Let's summarize what we have discussed until now. ROS have role as signal molecule. Thus, we can expect tumor regulation with antioxidant enzyme. Maybe this can be the next paradigm for cancer treatment. Thank you for listening.